I'm very happy to welcome Ryan Leslie here to the TV studio of the Mexico in Cologne. Ryan, welcome. I'm very happy that you're here.
Thank you.
Could you kindly tell us who you are and what you're doing?
Yeah, I'm Ryan Leslie, and I am here as the CEO of Superphone. So many people already know me as a musician, multi-platinum music producer, Grammy-nominated recording artist. And in 2013, I decided that I wanted to be on text with all of my followers. And so I gave my number out to 550,000 Twitter followers.
Okay.
And I needed to build a technology platform to help me answer all of those messages. And that's how Superphone was born.
How did this idea was sparked in you?
Yeah, I really feel like, connections, they're very weak on social media. And to have strong connections means that you will have a stronger possibility and a stronger chance of success. And I want to be successful, and I want the people who are around me to be successful. And so I decided that the phone number is stronger than a Twitter handle.
It's more personal.
It's more personal, and it's more powerful because you can easily just turn up from text to a phone call.
Yeah.
And I believe that phone calls are really what tell the difference between people that really care about you and people that are just kind of following because they want to
someone you know.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, okay. Could you tell us a little bit more about the concept of Superphone?
Yeah, so Superphone is really every aspect of email that is powerful right now, whether it's marketing automation, sales automation, folders, marking somebody as important, auto responses, vacation messages. All of that still needs to exist on text. And so that's what makes me excited about Superphone is that instead of using email, I use text because Superphone gives me all of those features.
Okay, nice. So you invented it for yourself to close the distance to your fans, to
exactly.
the people you interact with.
Exactly.
So how can companies utilize a Superphone?
Yeah, I think companies can utilize Superphone because success happens at the speed of communication. So whoever is important that you want to have a conversation with, you should have the best and most direct channel of conversation with that person.
Yeah.
So if you're a company, let's just say you sell flowers, you want to be on text with those customers because it's more convenient. And not only is it more convenient, it's more personal. And there's an incredible value of data that's exchanged in the conversation. So you can tell if someone uses emojis, you can tell how they respond, what times they respond, how quickly they respond. And so all of that data can help you to build a better relationship with your customers. And so I think up to this point, most customer relationship management software has been built around email as the communication protocol. And I believe that there's so much more power in text.
Yeah.
And so Superphone kind of serves as sales and marketing automation, but also customer relationship management. So really for me, as a musician, my fans were my customers.
Yeah.
And I wanted to have the best relationship possible with them.
Yeah.
So for companies and brands, your fans are your customers.
Okay.
And Superphone is a tool that allows you to have better conversations with them.
But what would you recommend a company to make it personal? Because for you, it's such an emotional connection you have to your fans. How can companies establish that kind of relationship? Yeah. Obviously, that's quite tough, but
yeah, I think what we've been seeing is that companies are already using influencers.
Yeah.
They're using I mean, actually, for as long as we can remember, we're using celebrities to create that kind of intimate connection to a brand.
Yeah.
So whether it's Rolex or whether it's Parmigiani Fleurier, whatever the name of the watch is, there's always a person that you associate with that brand. So with Capital One, we associate, in America, we associate Samuel L. Jackson. And they've got the tagline, what's in your wallet? And when it was McDonald's, there was Ronald McDonald. So there's always a personifying the brand is what makes it personal. And so right now, I think when brands are using influencer marketing and they're using Instagram to build that relationship, it's a very weak relationship. So if you gave the influencer who's representing your brand a phone number so that those people could really and truly connect with that influencer, you would be able to get much deeper insights about how much A, people care about the influencer, and B, people care about the brand.
So what makes Superphone different to the WhatsApp Messenger, where companies can also send push messages to their fans?
Yeah, so I think what makes it different is exactly what you talked about, is personalization.
Okay.
So what happens with Superphone is the more you talk to a customer, the smarter the platform gets. So right now, the way that Superphone is built, we can integrate with any other channel under the sun.
Okay.
So we can connect with any other app. So basically for me, I can say, hey, when Yara sends me an email, send her a text that says I got her email. Yeah. Or when someone buys something and pays on Stripe, send them a text that says, hey, I got your purchase.
Okay.
So the beauty of the actual conversation is that the conversation messages can be triggered by any external platform. So those kinds of integrations make the platform very, very powerful. The automation and the ability to also build a journey, mm-hmm. a conversation journey for that customer. So if someone starts on Stripe and then they send an email, it can change the journey of the conversation, and the technology is smart enough to be informed by the actions that are happening both externally and in the conversation. So we're very, very excited about what we've been able to build in that regard.
Sounds really exciting. And you already mentioned a lot of services of the platform, such as the communication tools and the
right.
connectivity. So
right.
sounds really
very excited about it.
What was like your personal funniest story that you had interacting with your fans through Superphone?
Wow, I've had so many great stories. But I'll have to say, one of my favorite stories is a friend of mine now by the name of T-Ball Van Rennie. And T-Ball sent me a text with a video of him actually performing one of my songs at a party. I think it was his birthday party. And that birthday party, everyone showed up at that birthday party in a Lamborghini. And I said, T-Ball, how are you able to do this? And he says, Ryan, anytime you need cars for a music video, just let me know. Mm-hmm. And I actually gave him a call and said, hey, look, I want to have 30 Lamborghinis in my music video. And guess what? He made it happen for me, no charge. And now I've got a video with 30 Lamborghinis behind me, thanks to T-Ball Van Rennie. So shout out T-Ball for that.
That's a pretty nice story.
Awesome.
So is there also a possibility for your fan base to interact with each other? Or is the community basically closed and is mainly interacting with the idol only?
Yeah, so I mean, I think it's great to be able to have social platforms mm-hmm. to allow people to communicate with one another. I think that it's important for the brand or the company or the small business or the entrepreneur to have that direct line of communication and have it be personal and have it be informed and get more intelligent based on how they communicate. So the way that Superphone is built, it's built for the entrepreneur or the small business or the brand to have direct one-on-one conversations with their customers or clients or whoever's important to their business.
Okay, I see. And you mentioned before that for you it's not anymore CRM, it's more PRM, the personal relationship management.
Absolutely.
So could you give us some more information about your beliefs in terms of personal management?
I mean, for me, the long-term vision of Superphone is the fact that all of us are really not using all of the connections that we have in our phone. So if I were to ask you right now, how many contacts do you have in your phone? You're probably only talking to 3%.
Yeah.
Luckily, maybe 10% of the people in your phone. And so my belief and my hope is that if we can increase the number of conversations that people are having with the contacts that they have in their phone, they're going to have way more opportunities and they'll be more successful. And for us, the mantra is always success happens at the speed of communication. So if you've got a great idea, that great idea is really only as big as the number of people that you communicate that idea to. And so Superphone really helps in maintaining, nourishing, building, and expanding personal relationships. And I think personal relationships are really the driver for success in any area of your life, whether it's personal or professional.
So I guess you already worked with a lot of companies. What would you actually recommend them in order to start a community? Because you already had a bunch of fans when you started Superphone.
Right.
But if I want to start a business today, how can I set up the community that is following me on Superphone?
Yeah, I think that the easiest way is just to give your phone number. out to everyone. I think I laid the blueprint for that. I just gave my cell phone number out to all my followers. So most brands have already been building a community somewhere, whether it's on Instagram or Twitter or Snapchat, YouTube, Facebook, wherever they're actually building a community, give people the opportunity to actually have that personal connection to you as an entrepreneur, as a small business, as a brand, and I guarantee that the results are going to be incredible. For me, 35,000 people texted me when I gave my number out, and one out of every two actually bought what I was selling. So you can imagine a 50% conversion rate over text versus whatever you're getting on email. Right now, email, 22% open rate, text, 98% open rate within 3 minutes. Text, also 45 to 50% click-through rate versus email, less than 4%. And so when you want real connectivity, and not just connectivity, but real conversions, text is the way to go. And so that's what we found at Superphone. And when we enjoy that kind of success, we want to share that success with as many businesses as possible. Because I really believe that the small businesses that are starting today, the small companies that are just starting and getting venture funding today, they have great ideas.
Yeah.
And those great ideas are going to be as valuable as the number of people that they can communicate those ideas to. If you've got a great product, I want to know about it as soon as possible. The best way to reach me is over text. And so we want to empower businesses, companies, brands to be able to take advantage of that powerful protocol.
So nice. So you said that you mentioned an incredible conversion rate of over 50%.
That's right.
Do you believe that customers tend to provide their telephone number only to companies or concept they believe in? So
absolutely.
It's also rarer interaction than on social media, and social
absolutely.
Media to follow.
Yes. And yeah. So I think that text is the most intimate part of our phones.
Yeah.
WhatsApp Messenger, probably one of the most intimate parts of our phones, right? And so I believe that when you give your number to someone or a brand, you really care about that communication, and that means that the connectivity and the conversion rates are going to go up just by nature of the fact that they're in the most intimate real estate in your phone.
But does that also mean that it's much harder to get followers on Superphone than on Instagram, if you compare?
Yeah, I believe so. And I think that that's better, though, because
higher quality
over quantity.
Yeah.
Right now, I've got 335,000 followers on my Instagram. And because of the algorithm, I don't even know if people are seeing my posts. The beauty of text is that when I send you a text, I'm sure you're going to see my post. Even if you don't respond, I know you've seen it. And I think that's what's important for me, because it's about sharing. It's about communicating.
Yeah. Ryan, thank you so much for sharing the beauty of texting with me.
Yes.
And all those nice insights. It was very nice to meet you.
It was nice
Enjoy
to meet you.
Enjoy the Mexico.
Yeah. And you got to give me your number.
Yeah, I will.
Okay. All right.
Thank you so much.
Take it easy.